What's up guys, my name is Dinesh Choudhury. So today we will discuss about Easy OCR library, which is basically an optical character reader library based on Python, PyTorch and PyTorch CV. So it is developed by Jedes AI and it is a 3 or 4 months old library basically. And this company has, this is basically a Thai company and they have launched it with the 40 plus languages support, like including Chinese, Japanese, English and Korean and so on. So you will be able to see that its final results are very pretty amazing. So I just want to give you walkthrough about this application and just wanted to set up like how to use this application. We'll do some OCR of some images and then in future we will definitely integrate some OpenCV and video live feeds with this library. Alright, so you can see over here that the supported languages are around 42 and all these languages are supported by Easy OCR, and this is the short form of all these languages, like EN for English and CH for Chinese and so on. So and there are some installation guide over here, and don't worry, I'll be teaching you the installation guide about it, and then you will be able to see that they have said that if you want to use this library with OpenCV, so you can use it with the NumPy array. You have to pass the objects or pixel values in the form of NumPy array, and then you will be able to use it with the OpenCV. So in coming future, I'll be definitely making the video on this also. And then how the all the parameters of the reader function, like what parameters are there to read the images basically. So you will be able to see that there is one parameter decoder which uses greedy algorithm by default, and then there is a beam search or word beam search. So in order to you can set the beam width, and then like by default it is 5. If you make it bigger number, then it will be more accurate. So accuracy will increase, but it will be a bit slower. So if you have GPUs in your PCs, then you can use it very well. And then for multiprocessing, you can set the workers parameter and the batch size, right? So if you will increase the workers, then it will do a multiprocessing in your images or a video feeds, right? And then if you will be able to see over here that whenever we do the OCR, then the best practice is to convert the images into a grayscale images, right? So because in the grayscale images, all the text fonts will be highlighted more, and the background will be white, right? So for that purpose, they have done the grayscaling of the images. So for that, they have make contrast, adjust contrast filters like this, right? So you can play around with these filters also. And then there is another parameter which is whitelist and blacklist. So if you want to blacklist some words, like you don't want to recognize particular words or some symbols, then you can make it into the blacklist, and this model will skip those values or words. Okay, all right. So now this is in the coming future, you can expect like Hindi languages, Arabic languages and all. So you know, and better obviously. And one more thing I want to tell you guys, that there is no documentation as such we have found as of now. So for this particular library, it is also written over here that they will implement it in coming future. So alright, so now this particular library is based on the Kraft algorithms. So you can see like they are using currently ResNet, and for sequence labeling they are using LSTM, and for decoding they are using CTC, and now it is available for us to use. So obviously, if you know all these concepts and if you know LSTM, right? So obviously, if you have studied RNN and some kind of a stuff, and maybe you have studied the CNN, then obviously you have done with the architecture. You have studied the architecture of ResNet, right? And then ResNet 50 and so on. You can study those paper, and obviously you can make these kind of a library by your own also. But it takes a lot of courage and hard work to implement this kind of a library and to make it open source, right? So yeah, so we will be quickly jump into the installation part. How can we use the installation and all into the local PC? So I have written some step over here, that these are the steps that you have to do. So you just need to search Anaconda, just right click on Anaconda and run as administrator, and then you have to it will open Anaconda command prompt like this. Okay, so now you will be inside Anaconda, you will be on your base environment. Okay, so this is my base environment. So maybe base is written over there, or maybe if something is not there, then it means that it's a base environment, right? So what we will do is we will create a separate environment for this particular OCR installation or OCR demo. Okay, and then we will activate it using this particular command, and then we will install prerequisite libraries like PyTorch and TorchVision. So always remember, we have to install PyTorch and TorchVision library to easy OCR library run on our local system, and then we will do the pip install easy OCR. So in order to create an environment, what you have to do is you have to run this particular command inside your Anaconda command prompt. So I'm just copying it, okay, and then you just need to hit enter. So my environment name is env_easyocr. So now I will install all the required libraries inside this particular environment. So you will be able to see that yes or no, and then you have to press Y and then hit enter. So it will install all the basic libraries for you, right? Now you have to activate the newly created environment. Okay, so I'm just copying it as of now. Then you will hit enter, and you will be able to see that env_ecocr inside the bracket over here. Now you are inside this particular environment. Okay, now you have to install this particular PyTorch library, and then you will be able to see that PyTorch and TorchVision library for PyTorch. It is very important for this particular task for ECOCR, right? So it will automatically install OpenCV image processing libraries and all these kind of libraries inside your environment. Okay, so you can see that it is done now, and now I have to install EasyOCR library inside this particular environment. So pip install EasyOCR, and now it is done. So now after doing that, you have to run one more command, which is, if it is not installed, pip install Jupyter notebook, if it is not installed. Okay, so if Jupyter notebook is not installed in your local PC, then you have to install pip install Jupyter notebook also. So let's wait for some time. All right, it is done. You have to write pip install Jupyter notebook, okay, like this, and hit enter. So what I have done is I have created one folder OCR, and inside OCR you have to copy the path till OCR, and then after installation of Jupyter notebook, you have to go to till that particular path where you have created your blank folder, which is OCR in my case. My Jupyter notebook is already installed on my local environment, env_easyocr, right? So as I have told you, I have created one folder OCR. Now it is blank as of now. Just don't look at all these pictures. Okay, so now what you have to do, you have to type cd, and then you have to go to till that particular path. Now I'm inside this particular folder, right? Now what I have to do is I have to write Jupyter notebook, that's it. And as soon as I'll hit enter, then you will be able to see that my browser will open automatically. Okay, and you will be able to see the blank dashboard like this, right? So I have three or four files for the demo, but just ignore all these files. You will see the blank, all the blank dashboard, right? So now what you have to do is you have to click on new, okay, and then python 3. Okay, so it will, as soon as you will click python 3, then you will see that untitled and this particular IPNB file like this, right? So now what I have done is I have given the name of IPNB file like EasyOCR and something, okay, EasyOCR demo, right? And just hit enter, and then I have started working on it. So now I have already done that. So I have already done in my one of the previous EasyOCR demo. Okay, so now first ever line which you have to run is import EasyOCR. So because we have already installed EasyOCR library, we are working on it. So you have to press shift enter, then it will run. okay, then you have to download a model. So as I know that my all of my images are as of now is in English, right? So I am downloading English model only. Okay, so you can pass n number of or 42 languages, like if you want to download Chinese model, and if you want to download Thai model, then you can enter n number of model or languages inside list separated by commas. Okay, then it will take some time and download all the models for you. Okay, so as of now I'm running all of my EasyOCR in CPU just for the demo. If you have CUDA installed in your local PC, then you can very well do it. You can make it true. Okay, and if true T capitals, and if you have if you are using it in Google Colab, then it's okay. You have to make it true, and because in Google Colab you have GPUs, right? And then after entering shift enter, then it will do some steps of downloading and it will be done. Then so as of now, let's assume I have some images like france.gfif. So this is my image which I want to in which I want to do the recognition of the characters, right? So welcome to France is my three words as of now in English. Okay, so you have to run shift enter. And what PIL is doing, PIL is a image library which is responsible to read the images from your current directory, okay, and draw it to the Jupyter notebook for you. All right, so now what you have to do, the next part is you have to do bounce equal to reader dot read text. So this particular function is very very useful for you. So as I have mentioned earlier, hover over here read text and press shift tab, then you will be able to see the signature of this particular method. Okay, so I have defined all of these things to you already, like what is the decoder, beam size, if you want to do it more accurate then you can increase it, then batch size, then contrast. So most of the people, if you are from deep learning background and machine learning background, then you should you will be able to know that what is batch size. Then if we have to play with the contrast of an image, then we can play around with it, like it's a grayscale images, you can change a bit of colors of it. Okay, so and then workers, if you are coming from a programming background, then you will be able to know that okay, if there is a worker, then I can do the multi-threading of it for the faster processing, right? And if you want to blacklist and whitelist some of the characters or some of the words, you can mention over here in the form of string. Okay, so as of now I'm not using all these words, all these parameters, but as of now I'm just giving the path. So this is the path of my image. So where my france.gfif is located, it is in the same folder which I have created. So you can see that this is my IPNB file and this is my france.gfif images. Okay, so all of these images are there. Okay, so we will be doing OCR for that. Okay, so now what I have done is I have done bounce equal to reader.readText and then path of the image, and then I'm printing bounce. Okay, so bounce is having my results as of now for OCR. So you just need to press shift enter and it will take some time. It will read this particular image and then what it will do, it will give you the list. Okay, and then you can see over here that it is giving you some of the list and tuple, like inside it there is a tuple. All right, so now you can see over here that welcome to France is my image, and you can see that welcome to is a word it has extracted with the confidence level of 97% accuracy, and then you can see the bounding boxes, the coordinates of bounding boxes. Okay, and then there is a bounding boxes again, and then this is a France again and with the 98% accuracy. So you will be able to see that if you want to see like in what this particular OCR has extracted or recognized from your image, then you can draw the boxes around it. So you just need to shift enter on this particular code. Okay, so it is taking your image IM which you have already imported through PIL library, and your final results. Okay, it has drawn some yellow color bounding boxes. Okay, so you will be able to see that if you print the length of the bounce has your final results. Okay, so if you will print that, okay, what is the length of bounce, so you will be able to see that it has recognized two characters. Okay, so welcome to and France. So now I have to see what is my result. So I have just make a simple for loop over here and then I'm printing the results. So as soon as you will enter, it has recognized the same thing. So now let's do one thing. So what we can do is we can check another invoice PNG. So this is my invoice one PNG. So let me show you how it looks like. So you can see that this is my PNG over here. Okay. And now if I have to see the results for my invoice, okay. So let me paste the path till my invoice. So this is my path, and now I have I'm reading all the characters inside it through EasyOCR function, which is reader dot read text. So you can see over here that it has read all these images. Okay, so you can see company name and then street address and then city address and all. So it is able to understand, but you will be able to see that it is not very good with the characters or the numerical characters. You can see that 5U00.0, right? So if you will see it, it has 5250. Okay, so now if you will draw the image, then you can see it has almost bounding box, done the bounding boxes of all the characters. Okay, so now if you will print the bounds or results, so it, you can see that it has recognized 48 words, you can say. Okay, so 48 words, when I say characters, so just think in the sense that I am saying a word. Okay, so like company name is a one particular word for it, for EasyOCR. Customer is a word for it. Okay, so when so just replace my whenever I'm saying that it is reading some character, just think that I'm saying word. Okay, now if I have done the for loop for it, then you will be able to see that this is my recognized values from this particular invoice. So yeah, so this is all about EasyOCR library. You can play around with this particular library, and I'm sure that you can use it in future in your upcoming projects. Okay, and then you can save all these data into your MongoDB and databases. Okay, so I hope you like the video, and if you really like the video, then just do subscribe my channel. Thank you.